Over a course of 25 years, Joseph Matamata lured people from Samoa to New Zealand promising employment. But instead he took their freedom, he took their money, he assaulted them and he reduced them to slavery. Yesterday he was sentenced to 11 years in jail. He's the first person to be found guilty on both human trafficking and slavery charges in New Zealand. The sentencing marked the end of a three-year investigation from Immigration New Zealand and the police. This is such an extraordinary story. We're going to do two interviews on it this morning. And the first is Immigration New Zealand's General Manager of Verification and Compliance, Stephen Vaughan, who's kindly come into our Wellington studio to join us now. Morena, Stephen, and congratulations. This is a great result, isn't it?
Morena, John. Yes, it is. It's a great result for the victims who bravely came forward to offer their evidence, and also a great result for a joint investigation with New Zealand Police, Immigration New Zealand, and the Samoan authorities.
Yeah, I want to pick up on that word bravely came forward. There is such a terrible power imbalance here, and the victims of slavery are so vulnerable that it's very unusual for them to come forward, isn't it?
Absolutely it is. And in this case, there was an absolute power imbalance, and society is often judged on how we treat our most vulnerable, and these people were absolutely vulnerable, some of the most vulnerable people we have in the country.
Yeah, we're going to talk about this after seven, how hard it is to get a conviction in slavery cases, and we're bringing in a law expert after seven. But in terms of mounting a case, it took 3 years basically to get through this to the guilty verdict and then to sentencing, right?
Yeah, that's right, yes. It's a complex across country with a lot of evidence that needs to be gathered and offered, and also with the number of victims. There were 13, and I think the victims really wanted three things. They wanted to be heard, they wanted to be believed, and they wanted it to stop. And we're enormously proud that we were able to achieve those three things.
This is not me having a go, because this is a triumph, and you brought an end to something terrible. But if we look at the offending, it began in 1994. You guys were alerted to it in 2017, and I worry about the intervening period and what it tells us about what might be going on in our country. Do you have the support in terms of man and woman power to be busting this kind of operation?
Well, Immigration New Zealand can't do this alone, and we have a fantastic working group, an interagency working group for trafficking in persons to assist us, with NGOs as well offering us advice. But I guess it comes down to the way that people treat as employers their employees, and without informing, educating and making sure that they're actually doing what they should be doing, it's a very, very difficult process to actually go through.
Yeah, it's really difficult. Is it also about our responsibility to notice? So Mr. Matamata was bringing people in from Samoa. They weren't participating in the life of the community. They were going to church and not speaking to anyone. I mean, they were clearly unusually quiet. Is it time we started noticing and asking people if they're okay?
Look, it's a difficult concept to grasp and very, very difficult to identify, but there are some indicators that people can actually pick up if they're actually close to and aware of what may be going on. And the retention of income, Mr. Matamata brought them to New Zealand to exploit them and retain the income, and didn't factor in their work into wages. They were paid very, very paltry wages, and in some cases they weren't paid at all. So that's a big indicator. Movement and freedoms that we would normally take for granted weren't afforded to these people, and also travel documents were withheld. So there's a number of indicators that if you are close to and aware of these types of things, that you can actually pick up.
So for people wondering what the hell slavery is and used to the depictions of slavery in the movies, how do you describe it? What was Mr. Matamata doing to these 13 people?
Mr. Matamata treated these people like commodities, like chattels. He deprived them of their freedoms, and he actually owned them. They worked for long hours and trying in difficult circumstances for protracted periods, for 6, sometimes 7 days, and that's how he treated them. He treated them like modern-day slaves.
And they had come without exception, I think. Am I right, from Samoa? And he was a Matai. Samoa is a culture which places great importance on deference to tribal leaders, to community leaders. And these people had nowhere to go, nowhere to turn, and felt a degree of shame on blowing the whistle on their own circumstance.
That's right. They came over on a promise that was a falsehood, a different life, money, opportunities, work. They were people from small villages, that people that weren't aware of employment regulations or employment law. They came because they trusted Mr. Matamata, And he defied them, and he put them to work, and he enslaved them.
And yesterday he was sent to jail for 11 years. It's a great result for Immigration New Zealand and for the police. Congratulations, Stephen Vaughan. We really appreciate you joining us, and a job well done.